India's agriculture, Indian entrepreneurs have started to identify and come up with solutions to some of the problems that historically have plagued this industry. By leveraging the power of technology, these entrepreneurs have been able to make farming in India more sustainable and profitable. Today, India has more than 450 agritech startups, and this number is increasing by 25% year on year. And so in this episode of Backstage with Millionaires, we're going to be taking a look at India's top 10 agritech startups that are using technology to boost the productivity of farmers, increase their incomes, and provide them with better livelihood opportunities. Starting things off at number 10, we have fresh food aggregator startup Aibono. Founded by Vivek Rajkumar in 2014, Aibono is India's first AI-powered seed-to-plate platform. Now, if you've never heard of seed-to-plate before, that's because Aibono invented it. It's their response to the popular concept of farm-to-fork, which only concerns itself with the journey of produce from the moment that it's harvested until the moment that it reaches the end consumer. Seed-to-plate, on the other hand, follows produce from the moment that the seed is sown, which is 60 to 90 days before harvest, until it reaches the end consumer. Rather than focusing on supply chain without having any control over produce, and when I say produce, I'm talking about highly perishable produce like carrots, broccoli, lettuce, and so on, which is a produce category that represents a $10 billion segment within the $250 billion fresh produce market, Aibono instead uses soil sensors, IoT devices, and imaging drones to collect farm data to be used in predictive analytics. These analytics are then used to help farmers make smart agriculture decisions, and these decisions, in turn, result in higher quality produce and a more abundant harvest. The company has partnered with 250 different retailers, which enables their network of 400 farmers to find buyers for their crops. So far, the startup has raised $3.5 million from investors like Mentera Venture Advisors, Artha India Ventures, 314 Capital, and Rebright Partners. Next up at number 9, we have Gurgaon-based agritech startup Intello Labs. The company was founded by Milan Sharma, Nishant Mishra, Himani Shah, and Devendra Chandani, all of whom are IIT Bombay alumni, in 2016. And it offers a wide variety of products like an AI-powered mobile app, which enables growers, packers, aggregators, exporters, and retailers to check the quality of their produce at different points in their supply chain, physical machines which segregate produce based on color, size, and visual defects in order to ensure 100% adherence to quality specifications, and handheld NIR scanners, which monitor bricks, pH, TSS, dry matter, moisture, and pesticide residue. These innovative products add value across the entire fresh produce supply chain and enable Intello Labs' customers to reduce the loss caused by wastage and defective produce. These customers include companies like Amazon, Reliance Fresh, and Dole. To date, Intello Labs has raised a total of $7.9 million from investors like Sama Capital, Omnivore Capital, Nexus Venture Partners, and SVG Ventures. Alright, moving on to number 8 now, we have on-demand farming equipment rental startup EM3 Agri Services. Founded by former Airtel CEO Rotash Mal and his son Aditya Mal in 2013, EM3 Agri Services enables farmers who can't afford to buy expensive farming machines and technologies to rent them instead. They're calling this Farming as a Service, or FAS, and this approach to farming is having a huge impact on farm viability by increasing their customers' agricultural productivity. So far, EM3 Agri Services has raised $13.3 million from investors like LGT Lightstone Espada, the Global Innovation Fund, and the Soros Economic Development Fund. Coming in at number 7, we have SaaS-based full-stack farm management startup CropIn Technology. Founded by Krishna Kumar and Kunal Prasad in 2010, CropIn provides AI-powered products that enable their customers to do things like capture vital data points about their crops while they're in the growth stage, monitor warehouse activities remotely, manage their supply chain, and improve transparency and traceability for end consumers. The startup claims to have worked with more than 225 clients, and they've helped over 2 million farmers across more than 50 countries. To date, CropIn has raised $13.5 million from investors like Chirate Ventures, the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, BeNext, and Anchor Capital. Next up at number 6, we have B2B agritech startup Bijak. Founded by Nikhil Tripathi, Daya Ray, Jitender Bidwal, Mahesh Chakotia, and Nukul Upadhyay in 2019, Bijak enables agricultural commodity traders and wholesalers to discover new suppliers, maintain ledgers, make payments, and access working capital through its app. The startup has a presence across 22 states and offers over 80 commodities through its network of traders and wholesalers. To date, Bijak has raised $14.3 million from investors like RTP Global, Omidyar Network, Sequoia Capital, Capital's Accelerator Program, Surge, Omnivore Capital, and Better Capital. All right, moving on to number five, we have end-to-end dairy technology solutions startup, Stellabs. Founded by Ranjit Mukundan, Ravi Shankar G. Shuror, Ravi Nale, Ramakrishna Adukuri, and Venkatesh Sesashayi in 2011, Stellabs helps dairy farmers and co-ops to maximize their profits by enabling them to monitor cattle with wearable pedometers called muons, procure milk with automatic milk collection units, which are controlled by an Android IoT device, and manage their cold chain across spaces like bulk milk coolers, silos, cold rooms, and deep freezers. All of these pieces of infrastructure fall under one roof, which is an IoT-powered supply chain optimization and digitization platform called Smart Moo, which is being used by companies like Haldiram's, Nandini, Milklane, Amul, and others. So far, the startup has raised a total of $18.8 million from Stride Ventures, the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, Bloom Ventures, and Omnivore Capital. Coming in at number four, we have full-stack agricultural services provider, Dehat. Founded by Shashank Kumar and Amrinda Singh in 2012, Dehat provides farmers at every stage of their agricultural journey with things like seeds and fertilizers at affordable prices, personalized assistance, soil testing, weather reports, microfinance, insurance, and connections with institutional buyers, all through a mobile app if they have a smartphone or by way of a phone call in their local language if they don't. The company has empowered more than 2 lakh farmers through its network across Bihar, Jharkhand, and Uttar Pradesh. They're looking to serve more than 5 million farmers by 2024, and in order to achieve this goal, the company has raised $19.3 million from Sequoia Capital, Omnivore Capital, Dutch Entrepreneurial Development Bank, FMO, and Egg Funder. Next up at number 3, we have one of India's largest agritech commerce platforms, AgroStar. The company was started by 2 brothers, Shardul and Sitanshu Seth, in 2013, with the goal of enabling farmers to procure high-quality agricultural inputs at affordable prices. Besides acting as an e-commerce platform for farmers, AgroStar also provides real-time advice from experts on how to manage crops and increase yields. While these services are accessible through a mobile app, farmers can also take advantage of AgroStar's services by calling AgroStar's helpline number. To date, the startup has raised $42 million from investors like Bertelsmann India Investments, Innovent Capital, Axel, and Chirate Ventures. Moving on to number 2, we have Chennai-based B2B agritech startup Waycool. Founded by Karthik Jayaraman and Sanjay Dasari in 2015, Waycool started as a B2C food supply chain startup called Sunnybee. However, after raising $2.7 million in 2017, the founders decided to pivot to a B2B business model because they felt that such a model would be much more scalable. Waycool offers its customers end-to-end supply chain solutions like farm inputs, food processing, branding, marketing, and last-mile distribution. The company works with 40,000 farmers to deliver 300 tons of food every day to their network of 8,000 customers. To date, Waycool has raised $60.8 million from investors like Lightbox, Dutch Entrepreneurial Development Bank, FMO, Innovent Capital, and LGT Lightstone Espada. And finally, coming in at number 1, we have B2B agritech startup Ninja Cart. Founded by 5 friends, Thirukumaran Nagaranjan, Kartiswaran KK, Ashutosh Vikram, Sharad Loganathan, and Vasudevan Chenatambi in 2015, the company was started as a B2C hyperlocal delivery platform for fresh produce like fruits and vegetables. However, only a few months in, the 5 co-founders realized that this business model wasn't sustainable. People were only buying from them because of the discounts that they were offering, resulting in low profit margins and a high churn rate. So in 2016, Ninja Cart pivoted to a B2B model. Their goal was to solve the supply chain problems that farmers and retailers were facing with fresh agricultural produce. By partnering with retailers, the company uses data analytics to predict demand, and that demand is then conveyed to the farmers to ensure a steady supply of fresh vegetables and fruits well in advance. Given that Ninja Cart controls the entire supply chain, there is consistent demand for farmers' produce, and this helps them to maintain a stable source of income. To date, Ninja Cart has raised $164.2 million from Tiger Global, Axel, Qualcomm Ventures, and Steadview Capital. All right, guys, there you have it. Those are our picks for the top 10 agritech startups in India. If you enjoyed this video, please leave us a comment and let us know. And while you're at it, you might as well hit the like button as well. And if you're not subscribed, now's a great time to do so. We upload new videos twice a week about Indian startups, entrepreneurs, and the latest news. So click subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified every time we upload a new video. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you guys next time right here on Backstage with Millionaires.